When we move to a signal, which is now, of course, pulsed or flutter shuttered like this, we might have a signal like this. Of course, the output we know is convolution of this to this one. And this is also a sync function. And of course, the big thing here is it is actually preserving all of the high frequencies. It's not going down into the low frequencies. By basically being able to do this, we actually now are able to get rid of modeling all of the low frequencies, and high frequencies are there. And this is my sync function. Again, I would get this by trying to compute the discrete Fourier transform of an image in this process. Recall again that convolution has a lot to do with Fourier transforms when we looked at all of our signal processing stuff in one of the earlier lectures. Here are the two signals next to each other. Full open shutter, sync function looks like this. And of course, a flutter shutter or a pulse shutter like this, the sync function looks like this. Never gets to some of the low frequencies, always basically. And again, you can see this, that there is a lot more low frequency information here. And because of the sharp lines and stuff like that, here we're actually seeing a lot more of the high frequencies. Simply, again, we flutter shuttered or pulsed our shutter to be able to get this image. We're interested in, of course, is the inversion, right? We're trying to invert this, being able to go from this to an original image. Of course, we can do this by doing inverse Fourier transforms. And again, in this case, we can now look at the inverse filters for doing these types of things. And of course, we look at the two different sine functions. The thing that is, and this is something I'm going to refer you to back to some of the literature on signal processing, this kind of a filter is unstable, while a signal like this is much more stable because, again, it's only kind of capturing the high or low frequencies in this instance, and we can represent this much better to be able to kind of do the inversion to compute our signals. And that's the basic idea here, is that trying to do an inverse discrete Fourier transform, this kind actually would be much more suitable for our reconstruction. Let's look at the examples. In this case, I'm going to basically show short exposure, long exposure, and coded exposure. For a short exposure, of course, no light, we get a very thin, but of course we get a nice crisp image. Long exposure, we get a lot of blurriness. Coded exposure, we get blurriness, but a lot more high frequency information still there. And of course, we can de-blur this using the approach I kind of talked about, and this is what we would get, much crisper image. If you were to de-blurring this with a variety of different approaches, we might still get some incompleteness. Or in this case, by doing it the method I was doing with discrete Fourier transforms and stuff like that, we will get more bars. By the way, just to compare, this is the ground truth image that we would have had if we actually had captured it correctly. And this one looks pretty good. There's a little bit of noise and there's a little bit of banding going on, but much better than this. And that's the basic idea of this flutter shutter camera, being able to kind of use this knowledge to be able to now reconstruct an image that knows how the variations happen. Again, we know the code, we know the output, we can deconvolve with the knowledge itself to help us figure out how to actually generate a reconstruction that's much more true to what the original image would be. Same idea as what we looked at for coded aperture, except this time, of course, it's a coded shutter. Let's see some examples produced by these authors in their paper. Here is an example using this camera here of basically looking at a car. Of course, if this car is moving fast, you cannot actually see the license plate, which is here. But, of course, if we had a flutter shutter camera, you should be able to reconstruct from this and actually get the license plate number. Another example of the same thing. Again, somebody says, I want more detail here. This is the original image, but if I had a flutter shutter camera, I should be able to generate more. Another example with the cars again. This is the original image. Let's just focus in there. And actually, the whole car image can be regenerated. And if you notice, we can actually now start looking up and start even reading some of the numbers and additional detail. Another input image. We can rectify the cropped image here. And again, create a de-blurred result, much more crisper.